Just think of New Orleans. And if you haven't seen that town, boy, it's a pity. There's nothing like New Orleans. It will remind you of old-fashioned lace. A glass of wine will greet your smiling face. And if you ever seen a brown-eyed gal like mine, boy, you down in New Orleans.
WHBQ-TV presents Memphis State University Football, The Charlie Bailey Show, with the voice of the Tigers, Paul Hartledge, and MSU head coach, Charlie Bailey.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to the visitors' locker room at the Superdome in New Orleans, Louisiana, where Saturday night the Memphis State Tigers had a fight on their hands, but they came up short 20-19 to the Green Wave of Tulane. Coach, this is a game kind of coulda, shoulda, shoulda.
Yeah, that's correct. We had our opportunities to win the football game, and we didn't. Really felt that our young men fought throughout the ball game, and we came up with some big plays and played inspired football, and you know, what else can I say? You know, we missed a couple field goals we should have had, and we didn't get the job done. And I guess what you say is that's part of football, and it really hurts me inside because I really feel for our young men more than me as a head football coach, and winning's everything, and I've told people that many times, and that's what I tell my players, and I really feel for them because it really hurt me coming into the locker room and see these young guys, you know, crying, tears in their eyes because they gave it everything that they had and just came up short. And we made a mistake there at the end of the ball game, a couple of them, and that's what cost us the football game.
Well, the bottom line is winning and losing, but you have to be so proud of this team because they look so much better tonight than they did a week ago against Louisville.
Well, I really feel that, you know, they'll fight you. They really will. And a lot of people have been down on our football players at times, but I really feel that they'll fight you. And week in and week out, I really feel that they'll come out there and perform. Tonight, we made some big plays, like I say, on both sides of the football, but we just came up short.
Well, as they start carting away everything from outside, that's the beeper you hear from the Heister forklift trucks. We're going to take a break and come back with first half highlights next on The Charlie Bailey Show.
The Charlie Bailey Show is brought to you by the Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Memphis.
Tiger, 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 Tiger.
Coach, the game started out Saturday night, three and punt. I think there was one first down in the first two series for either teams, but then the Tigers got it cranked up with Timmy Jones back at quarterback.
Yes, first time we went out there, we were a little sluggish and kind of running around into each other, and Tulane, they were the same way. They couldn't complete any passes. They were dropping passes, but you know, all at once we got a drive going, and we ended up going down and getting a field goal.
Charles Wilson has been the big play guy, and Timmy Jones looked real good hitting him for a 15-yard gain in the third drive of the game.
Yes, we sprinted out and threw a out route to Charles and made a big catch for us.
Then the big play, 36 yards all the way down to the Tulane 22-yard line.
Yes, where we have an all streak on, and he hit Charles down the sideline, and once again, Timmy threw the pass a long, long ways, and they were in cover two, and their strong safeties trying to play half-field coverage, and we send two people down, and he couldn't cover it.
You get the ball inside the 20-yard line, even if it's the first drive of the game. It's important to get it in the end zone, but we have to settle for a field goal.
Yeah, once again, I'm disappointed in our offense. Anytime we get inside the 20, we haven't been able to punch it in, And that really concerns me. And, you know, but anytime you get down there inside 20, you got to get some points on the scoreboard somehow. And at least we got 3 points.
Well, the Tigers are up 3-0, and they hold Tulane a couple of times. But finally, Tulane starts to move until Pierce gets really whacked, and Eddie Moore comes up with the big play.
Oh, then Eddie, he played good all night long, you know. That guy was all over the football field and just played inspired football, and I'm really proud of Eddie Moore.
Fortunately, the Tigers can't go anywhere, and Tulane finally gets himself on track late in the first quarter, and Hunter, number 32, pretty good runner for Tulane. He gets 17 yards.
Yeah, what did we were playing, you know, they run a little off-tackle play, and we weren't making that thing bounce outside the way we wanted to, and he was hitting up in there, and later on we made an adjustment, and we were able to take care of that play.
Second and 10 from the 17, and Jones hits his receiver in the back of the end zone. That was a tough call, tough play.
Yeah, it sure was. You know, anytime a quarterback gets out back here and he starts scrambling a little bit, you know, we got some problems, and he just had too much time to throw the football.
All at once, it was 7-3 in favor of Tulane, but Charles Wilson took care of that in a hurry.
Wiggins' kick will be fielded by Wilson at the 4. Wilson is up past the 15, out to the 20, finds a hole up the middle. Here goes Charles Wilson. He's out past the 45. He's got only Wiggins to beat. Away for the touchdown, Memphis State.
Goodbye. Just a straight wedge return then by Memphis State. They had the defense all wadded up pretty much in a straight line, got the little crack in the seam, and then it was just him and the kicker, and that is a mismatch.
96 yards, there he goes.
Boy, he did. We had a middle return on, and boy, he popped that thing, and he went all the way, and that got everybody inspired. I'm talking about, you talking about our bench, our fans there, and they got everyone emotionally ready to play.
Well, you look like a genius now putting him back there to return kickoff.
No, he's a big play football player, and he can make big plays for us.
Well, the Tigers up now by a score of 10-7, but then Tulane comes right back. Terrence Jones, the kid's tough.
Boy, he is. He is some type of football player. You know, we've had him back there quite a few times tonight, but the guy just made big plays after big plays against us. You know, he didn't complete a whole lot of passes, but he would scramble around and throw the ball downfield and come up with big plays.
Well, after the big 50-yard pass completion to McIntosh, the Tigers hold him inside the 10-yard line, and Wiggins comes on and kicks a 22-yard field goal. Now it's the Tigers' turn to come back. And the big Bill Moody, he ran well for you tonight.
Oh, Billy ran quite well. We ran what we call a trap play, and this is the first time we really had that play in where we pass influence by the guard and creates a surge by the defensive lineman, and we're able to trap him and get some big plays.
About three series later, the Tigers at the 48-yard line. Timmy Jones goes deep this time, and it's picked off by Price. He had a couple times.
Yeah, Timmy a couple times tonight tried to force the ball in there down the sideline, and once again we have what we call an all streak on and F flat, and you know Timmy didn't read strong safety. What he did, he kind of read the corner instead of strong safety. Strong safety overplays out, then you got to throw it back inside, and if the strong safety plays it perfectly, you got to go to the fullback in the flat.
But if turnaround is fair play, Eddie Moore comes up with fair play, intercepting the pass at the 13.
What? Once again, big play Eddie Moore made some big plays for us.
Tulane had a chance to take the lead at the half, but Eddie Moore's interception, the clock runs out, and the Tigers and the Green Wave go into the locker room at 10-10. You'll see an awful lot of tie action when we go to the second half right after this timeout. It seemed the Tigers started getting more pressure on Terrence Jones, and this time the Space Dog comes up with the big play deep in their territory. He had a chance to catch one of those in the first half.
Yeah, he picked that little thing off, and, you know, great, gave us great field position there. And we'll be on, about the 9-yard line, and we didn't get the ball in, and that really displeased me.
Now it's a chip shot, though, 21-yard field goal attempt by Johnny Butler.
Yeah, Johnny... Oh, you got to make those kind. You know, anytime you're up there that close, you got to make those. You know, whenever you're out there kicking those 30 and 40 and 50 yarders, you know, it's a little bit different. Whenever you get those chip shots, that's just like kicking a PAT, and you got to make those kind of field goals.
Well, Tulane takes over at the 20. They drive all the way down to the Tigers' 3 and then make a mistake. Terrence Jones tries to force the ball in, and Reggie Dubose intercepts it. I thought he was in the end zone.
Well, Reggie was. He, you know, when he caught it, but then he ran out, and they probably should have stayed in the end zone. And, you know, he's got to learn by those mistakes. But he made a big play for us.
We're thinking now the Tigers had terrible field position, just get a first down, and they do. Gerald White, who ran like the Gerald White of old. He hit this hole here like crazy.
Gerald, he did. Gerald ran the counter OT quite well for us and ran the, you know, the lead draw a couple times quite well. And Gerald is, you know, he's healthy again, and I'm glad to see him running quite well.
Now the Tigers get into Lane territory, and it's up top from Timmy Jones to Ray Kraft for 41 yards.
Yes. Once again, Timmy, he read the blitz, and they were in man coverage, and he hit Ray, and, you know, he just kind of threw it up, and Ray, he judged the ball quite well and came up with the catch.
Now Marvin Cox comes in, fullback. We got to start calling him Touchdown Cox. He's touched the ball about three times. His second touchdown on the little pass.
Split back formation behind Timmy Jones. Timmy Jones keeps it, throws it into the end zone. Touchdown, Memphis State. Marvin Cox makes the catch.
Great play then, great play. What made that play go was the play action fake. You've got to sell your play action fake to make your pass go. He sold it well. The defensive secondary came up to stop the run, and he just tossed it over the secondary.
Marvin Cox that time lined up in the hip position on the slot to the right. Made the fake into the line. Cox was wide open in the corner of the end zone.
Yeah, we lined up in a strong set with a wing, and we had a little play fake inside. Just sent him in the flat, and he was wide open for the touchdown.
Now it's time to stop Tulane, but Terrence Jones engineers the drive down. A 20-yard pass to Jerome McIntosh gets him out of trouble.
And, you know, whenever we had a chance there to really go after them, you know, get their jugglers, we didn't get the job done.
Second down and 17 at the Tulane 48-yard line. He goes deep.
Yeah, we were in what we call cover four, four field, and Randall Cooper let the guy get behind him. You know, he scrambled. He got back. We got a little pressure. He scrambled to the right, and, you know, the guy was open down there, and we can, you know, anytime he starts scrambling, then the secondary's got to play deep, and we didn't do it, and they came up with a big play, and that was really a big, big play of that football game.
Well, the touchdown for Tulane tied the game up at 17-17. Memphis State goes nowhere. Tulane comes back, and Jones's pass is intercepted by Eddie again, his third interception of the game.
It sure did, and that gave us great field position again, and, you know, got us an opportunity to maybe go down and score.
This time, Timmy Jones decides he's not going to play favorites. He goes to Chris Martin for 18 yards.
Yeah, what we did, ran a little bend route where Chris comes over the middle, and Timmy read it, and we got a completion.
Tigers get inside the 10 one more time, all the way down to the 5-yard line. Fourth down, 22-yard field goal attempt, and this one misses again.
Yeah, once again, you know, we were almost right in the middle of the field whenever he missed this one, and once again, you got to make those kind. You know, you can't let those slip away.
The game stays tied. There's just about 4 minutes left, and Timmy perhaps held this ball just a little bit too long and got sandwiched.
Yeah, well, we had a sprint out called, and Timmy sprinted out, and receivers covered, but then he just kind of started moving around instead of protecting the football, and they hit him, and there was a fumble, and they recovered.
Well, the 15-yard penalty moved Tulane back, but Wiggins had a 45-yard field goal attempt, his longest of the season, and he nails it.
He sure did. He made it. We didn't make it.
Tigers have one more chance to go to Andy Whitwell, the two-minute quarterback, and it pays off at first. He goes to Chris Martin for 20 yards. Memphis State has it now in Tulane territory. There's still 40-some seconds left to go. We go deep.
Yeah, we had what we call steamers on, and that's where we send four people deep. But, you know, Andy kind of threw it probably there in double coverage, and, you know, whenever they're all covered like that, he needs to throw the ball to the outside receiver, and then from that point you can throw it out of bounds because we had time left, maybe get a field goal and tie the football game.
Well, it wound up there were 2 seconds left on the clock after the Tigers had held Tulane, and Micah Noyce, their punter, runs out of the end zone for the safety with 2 seconds left to make the final score, Tulane 20 and Memphis State 19. We'll be back with the stars of the game plus our Tiger snapshot after this timeout on the Charlie Bailey Show.
Man, I'm just want to let you know that I'm proud of you, okay? I'm very proud of every one of you in this room.
Offensive player of the game, absolutely no question, has to be Charles Wilson once again.
He made a couple big catches. You know, that guy can get up in the air and catch him too, and And then that kickoff return, wasn't that a great one? I mean, the guy hit up the middle, and all at once he turned on the burners. And I was running down the sideline. You know what? As slow as I am, I'm a moose Scotty. No, that was really a great effort by Charles, and also it was great blocking up front. And we need big plays like that. And Charles Wilson is that type of football player. He can come up with big plays.
96-yard return, second longest in Memphis State history. Also 152 yards in return yardage, also second best in Memphis State history. Only Jerry Harris had more back in 1983. Defensively, Eddie Moore, three interceptions and a fumble recovery.
What else can you say about Eddie Moore? He really played great football tonight, came up the big plays whenever we needed him. He was hitting people and knocking the ball loose and fumble recovery. And Eddie is quite a competitor, and I'm really proud of him. You know, they called him out there for face mask one time. I don't know if it was or not, but, you know, he's just a great competitor, and he came here to play tonight, close to his hometown, and I guess his parents were here, and I bet they're real proud of him, and I'm real proud of him as a football player.
Well, those three interceptions also tie a Memphis State record set by Ole Cordell and Keith Simpson. Now it's time for the Tiger Snapshot. This week, it's fullback Wayne Pryor.
I think Wayne's been the leading rusher for 2 years here. He's the leading rusher right now. I think he's also the second leading pass receiver for the team last year and again this year. I think you're very accurate. Wayne Pryor does well. The team does well.
He was a redshirt his freshman year, and that first spring that we were out there, and we were moving everybody around. I had him fullback and tailback and just trying to find backs. And all at once, Wayne came to the top that fall, and he took over the starting job, and he's had it ever since.
You like carrying the football, don't you?
Yeah, I love carrying the football. You know, the coaches might right now think, you know, that's the only thing I like to do, carry the ball and not block. But, you know, I just been having trouble on my blocking, and that's one thing I got to get better at.
What are the qualities that make a good fullback?
Well, the main thing is the blocking. You know, that's the started off, the blocking is more like a lineman. But, you know, Memphis State, they made me more, you know, as a runner and then a blocker. But you got to be a blocker and, you know, be able to hold your block and run the ball.
Wayne seems to kind of downplay his blocking ability.
Well, that's probably, if you want, it's an area that he works on, and we try to encourage you to work on, because that's not a natural thing. I think it's probably more natural, if you think about it, it's more natural when you are headed towards a very large moving object to avoid it. So it's an unnatural thing to want to run into that large moving object, and that's a thing a fullback does a lot. So that's the area most backs, fullbacks particularly, you know, need to work on, and he's continually getting better at it.
In order to be a complete back, you got to be able to catch a football. A lot of guys, you know, as running back, the fullback position, they can run it, but they can't catch it, don't have good hands, but Wayne does have good hands. We use him a great deal on what we call our bootleg passes, our counter passes, where the fullback goes out in the flat, and, you know, he's been open about every time we throw on that ball, and, you know, before long, somebody's going to try to take it away, but if they do, they take that away, then they're going to give up something else, but he does a good job.
How do you like that wishbone?
The wishbone? I really ran it all the whole game because, you know, that's the fullback. You know, you don't block them much, and I ain't saying I don't like to block, but, you know, that's not one of my favorite things, and the fullback gets to run the ball a lot.
Is the type of football player a coach loves to have. He loves to play the game.
So I just got to keep a smile and keep going.
Sometimes I think it's tougher to take a loss when you play well than when you play poorly, because when you play poorly, you know
what has to be done the next week.
Yeah, we did. We played quite well. Made some big plays. That's what football's all about. Guys play with a lot of motion. They were ready to play tonight. You know, it's a shame that you got to lose those type of football games, but I got to give Tulane credit. They also play good. And we're just going to have to rebound and come back to Memphis. And we're finally home, you know.
Home cooking this week.
Yeah, we haven't played too many games at home. Played one game, and, you know, those three road games have been quite tough. But we hung in there tonight, and it's a shame we lost. But, you know, once again, I'm real proud of the football team.
Mississippi State is a different kind of football team, too. The Tigers play next week. They scored big points against some people, but yesterday or Saturday they get shut out by Florida.
Boy, they're snake bit, too. You know, they play good football. They really have. They beat Louisiana Tech, and they lost to Vanderbilt in a very close football game. They come back and play Georgia, very, very close. And then they go down and play University of Florida, and they lost down there 17-0. So they played quite well. They can throw the football, and you know, they're like us. They're 1-3, and it's a shame because they played quite well, and, you know, they ended up 1-3, though.
Well, it's the Bullies and the Tigers. Next Saturday night, kickoff at 7:30. Kix 106 and the Tigers radio network will be on the air at 7 o'clock with the Charlie Bailey pregame show. Until then, for the coach, I'm Paul Hartledge. Thanks for joining us. Have a nice Sunday.
The Charlie Bailey Show has been brought to you by the Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Memphis. Think Memphis State, think Coke. And by Cellular One of Memphis. Crown Distributing and the Adolph Coors Company. Massey's Foreign Auto Parts. And by Shoney's, America's Dinner Table.